Yes, it is as gross as it sounds, because it is literally what it sounds like. So if you haven't heard of fecal transplants, it is a strange concept to wrap your head around. Essentially, what it is you take a turd or a poop from a healthy person, you mix it up with some liquid, and you inject it into a sick person to try to make them better. So why would you do this? Does this actually work? This sounds kind of crazy. Well, it did sound kind of crazy until a few years ago. In my postdoctoral lab, my postdoc advisor, Eric Alm, has pioneered some of this work and started a company that actually creates material for these fecal transplants called Open Biome. These transplants have been shown to be incredibly effective for treating a very specific disease, which is C. difficile, Clostridium difficile infections. So I only have statistics from a few years back, but I remember a few years back, about 30,000 Americans every year were dying from Clostridium difficile infection. It is the second most common, I believe, hospital-acquired infection, second only to staph infections. It tends to strike in really young people or in elderly people, people who already have sort of compromised immune systems or compromised guts. And a big risk factor for getting C. diff is taking antibiotics. So you go in, you take antibiotics, you might get colonized, and the next time you have another round of antibiotics or another depletion of your diversity, suddenly you get sick and C. diff takes over and you get really bad diarrhea. 70% of people that go and get treated with vancomycin, an antibiotic, to treat this C. diff infection, 70% of people are fine, they get better, they go home. But about 30% of those folks, they end up getting what's called recurrent C. difficile. And once C. diff recurs, the likelihood that antibiotics are going to be able to get it in the next round or to cure it or resolve it is very, very low. And so recurrent C. diff, you end up getting in this vicious cycle of constantly having to be on different rounds of antibiotics. And some people live in this cycle for years to the point where their colons are so damaged they have to be surgically removed, parts of them have to be surgically removed. And then that's where all these complications like sepsis can come in, and that's where people die, essentially. So it was, in some cases, an incurable disease, antibiotic resistant, really virulent, really nasty, killed a lot of people. But we figured out that if you just squirt a little healthy poop up someone's bum who has this infection, 95% resolution to that disease. There's been many clinical trials now. I think the efficacy varies between the high 80s and low 90s, but more than 90% of the time someone gets a fecal transplant, they're completely cured of this incurable disease that was killing people before. So it's really the first example of using the microbiome, engineering the ecology of the microbiome to treat disease. And I find this to be incredibly exciting. It shows that our field is relevant to medicine. And I would predict that in a decade or so, we might actually even see in medical schools entire programs where students will focus on the microbiome as one of their specialties. So I think the future is bright for using the microbiome to treat disease. Fecal transplant's this first example. They're trying to apply it to other diseases now. So I know it's being applied to inflammatory bowel disease. There has been more complicated. It's not quite as effective. And we seem to find this effective super poopers, where there are particular donors who are really good at treating patients with inflammatory bowel disease and other donors who have no effect. And so we still don't really know what the secret sauce is. We don't really know the active ingredient yet. And that's a lot of companies and a lot of labs are really quickly trying to pin that down, because there's a lot of pharmaceutical money involved in making products that can do this without having to give someone a poop transplant. It's exciting. It's an exciting time to be in the field, because with this initial proof of concept, now we're starting to get more focused in creating therapeutics that target very specific diseases, and just be able to engineer the microbiome to improve human health.